In this video, we're going to take a look at AnimTrails as particle systems. These are a way to create particles that will follow the bones of an animated mesh. So really, to make the most of this, we could use an animated mesh. Let's start off in our My Particle folder that we've been working in, and let's create a new folder. I'll call it AnimTrails. We'll jump down inside of it. Actually, we're not going to jump down inside of it at all. We're going to go up to our game folder. And again, as a reminder, I am in the Content Examples project, which you should be able to download from your launcher. Let's search for jumping jacks. And you should find at least one of these. I think I've already copied off one, but you should only see one, probably. It doesn't matter which one you grab. Let's go ahead and just make a copy of that and put that in our AnimTrails folder. So we'll copy that there. I just want to have my own local copy, and you'll see why here in just a moment. So we can go ahead and empty that out, and let's double click this. This is going to open it up in Persona. Now, if you are opening Persona for something close to the first time, you might see your display info, which, depending on your screen size, might be eating up a lot of your overall viewport. So I would go ahead and hide that. So that's all this is, just a guy doing jumping jacks, looking all impressive and stuff, and like he could use some serious skincare products. What we're gonna do is drag him onto our little end pedestal, like so. So that's it, super quick, super easy. He is kind of in the dark, but we're gonna use that to our advantage because here in just a minute, he's gonna do something super bright and colorful. Now, over here off the screen, I can go ahead and close Persona. We don't really need that open anymore. Let's see though, we do need a special material for this. So I'm going to right click and create a new material, which we will call mat_animtrails. And we'll double click. And what we want is a vertically running gradient. And we'll make it run from bottom to top. So let's start with a texture coordinate, like so. And this time, if we single out, use a component mask. If we single out the red channel, this gives a, well, it's a horizontal one, so let's do the green channel instead. So there's a vertical gradient that's running up from the bottom to the top, is going from light to dark. So that's what we're gonna go with. Let's get particle color. It would help if I could spell particle, or at least if I could type it. I'm pretty sure I can spell it, right? Now let's hold down the M key and click and make a couple of multiply nodes. So we will take color and multiply, and we'll plug that into emissive color. Also, let's take our overall material node, and we're going to set its blend mode to translucent. We'll set our shading to unlit for this, and we'll multiply alpha, and use that to drive opacity. So if we take a look at that on a sheet, there's what it looks like, which is great. That's exactly what we want. Okay, so now with that done, yes, we want to save changes, absolutely. Now let's make our particle system, right click, new particle system, double click, and immediately add a type data of AnimTrail. Here's the thing, we will not be able to preview this inside of Cascade. We need a skeletal mesh to do that, so we can really only preview it inside of the actual viewport on the mesh, or we could preview it inside of Persona. Either way, we need to set a few things up before we leave. So let's go into the required module. We'll add our material into that by dragging that into the material slot. So that should work out well. We don't really need initial, actually, you know what? Let's leave everything alone. Let's get it set up on the skeletal mesh and you'll see why we make all the changes that we're gonna make. So I'll double click and open up jumping jacks. Now to make this follow our character, there's a couple of ways to do it. One is through blueprint, another way is through anim notifies. We're gonna do the anim notify method just for overall simplicity because it's really fast and easy to set up. So by the way, if you haven't quite caught on, this is something that you could really use for a lot of different things. A popular use of it is like for sword swings, or like, you know, if you have a
character with a sword that appears to be made of a laser that makes a certain kind of humming sound when you swing it through the air and leaves a little arc.
This is how you could create that arc. So let's see, we're going to start off by creating the Anim Notify to make this happen. And what we want is for these Anim Trails to basically come off of this guy's forearms. So it would help if we knew where those bones were. Of course, you can preview that over here in the skeleton. We have lower arm and hand. So lower arm L and lower arm, lower arm L and hand L. And there's also lower arm R and hand R. So I'm going to right click here in my notify bar. So here inside of persona, which I'm not going to spend a lot of time on, you can just follow along for now. We'll keep things relatively focused. If you don't see the same thing I see, I guess I should mention this. Make sure you double click that jumping jacks animation, because that's just going to open up exactly what I want you to see. There is a little area at the bottom with your notifies bar. Right click in that, and you're going to add a notify state for a trail. It's that simple. Now, this has a duration, so if you drag the little flags for it, you'll see you can kind of spread them out like so. We do need to set up the template that we need in here, so I need to kind of show my matte anim trail, I'm sorry, my new particle system, which I should probably rename. Let's right click and rename that to p_animtrails. And yeah, that's fine. We're going to drag that into the PS template, which is a particle system template. Now we need to give this a first and second socket name. That'll be lower arm underscore L, and it's gonna help you as you type that out. And then we'll do hand L as well. Now if we watch, nothing is showing up right now, but that's okay. We're not too worried about that at the moment because we've still got some things that we need to set up over in the particle system. So let's go ahead and get the particle system open. Now again, we have our color over life. We've got our lifetime setup. There's one more thing about our material that we need to take into account that is not super apparent at the moment. We can take our also take our lifespan. Let's set that up to like 5 seconds. Oh, there you go. And it's starting to kick out those trails. So we needed a little more lifespan on there. Now, here's where this starts to get a little bit fun. So you see that the trails get emitted only within the duration of this notify. So real quick, I'm gonna scrub my time slider here underneath my viewport. We want this to start right as he actually begins the jumping jack motion. So he's kind of settling in, there's a little bit of anticipation. And then right here, he starts to perform his first jumping jack. That's where we want the initial trail to start appearing. Then he's gonna do some jumping jacks. He's gonna stop right about here and just return to a standing pose. So right as he ends that jumping jack, that's where we want the effect to end. So we want this to only take place while he's doing jumping jacks. So now let's go ahead and play that back. And oh, he's doing something. But there's some really weird behavior coming out of this, and we're probably going to change the direction of our materials gradient. But that's okay; we can do that. We'll solve one problem at a time. See how this check kind of keeps going up into the air over and over again? Well, that's because we still have our initial velocity. So let's go ahead and delete that. Jump back over and watch Owen do his thing again. Now notice we only see these trails appear when his hand is coming down. Have you considered why that is yet? Can you figure it out? I'll show you here. Here's a hint. If we rotate around to the other side, now we only see them when his arms go up and not when they're coming down. That's because the material is one-sided. So really quickly, let's go into our material and select the material itself. And there's a little checkbox on the material for two-sided. Check that, apply, and save. And we can close that, we don't need it anymore. Actually, well, we might need it. Let me not speak too soon. So let's go ahead and get him doing some jumping jacks again. If you need to, like if he suddenly loses the ability to play because of focus, just double click on the jumping jacks animation in the asset browser and he'll start right back up. That's actually the completed version that I used for prototyping. So let me grab the other one that we're currently working on. We'll know because it's got the asterisk on it. And let's go ahead and hit play. Boom, boom, boom. So that's looking great. The only thing is I would change the direction of the gradient for the trail, and I would probably also pull down the lifetime of the trail a little bit. So let's take the lifetime and we'll set it to only about maybe a second. And over here with Owen, let's go ahead and get him playing again. We can fast forward all the way to the end and hit play to make it wrap around a little more quickly. Yeah, that's pretty good. Now, in the material, we're going to change out the direction of our gradient, which is really easy. Just take your component mask, switch it from green to red, and apply. Now let's go back over here to Owen, and we'll just hit play. And there we go. So that's looking pretty good. Now the only other thing I'd want here is I would like this to be on both arms. That would be a lot nicer. So what I'll do is here in the notifies list, we'll just click plus to add a new notify. I'll right click pretty much at the beginning of the first one and we'll add a new notify state for a trail. And we will set the flags to essentially match what's exactly beneath it because he's doing jumping jacks with both arms at the same time. We can take the template and just drag in our particle system. This time we'll do lower arm underscore R and hand underscore R. And we'll let that cycle again. And now both arms are leaving trails behind. I'm pretty sure the gradient is running in exactly the opposite direction too. So I would fix, so it's running in the right direction, but it needs to be inverted. And the easiest way to invert something is just to one minus it. So we can just take our texture coordinate and we can hold down the O key and click and that'll make a one minus and plug that in like so. And now if we apply that and play, there we go. Awesome. Okay, so now outside of that, the thing I'd like to do to make this a little nicer is we have color over life. Let's make this kind of fun and interesting. So we can't preview this, but we can do some fun stuff here in Cascade. Let's open up our color points. We currently have two of them. We're going to take the in value and pull that. So that's the first color. Instead of being at the actual time of birth, we're going to set this to about 0.25. So that means this will not only be the color of birth, but it's going to maintain this color for the first quarter of the lifetime. And the out value will just be straightforward red. So one in red and zero in blue and green. Then we're going to add another point. I'm going to take point one, which is now in the middle, and we'll set the in value to 0.5, take the out value and set it to 0 for red, 1 for green, 0 for blue, so now it's green. We'll take the in value for the last point now, and we'll set that to 0.75, and we will set the out value to 0, 0, 1. So we're going from red to green to blue. We've just made a rainbow. If we take this and throw it into the curve editor and size it up, you can see how that works. But right now it's a linear relationship, which I really don't want. So we can fix that here in the curve editor by holding down Control and Alt and dragging a little marquee selection box around all of these keyframes and setting them to auto clamped. And now we have a nice blend between red and green and blue. So now if we come back over here, Owen has got a nice little rainbow effect going on. And we can check that out in the level. However, to see it, we have to simulate. And he's got like this crazy disco inferno rainbow effect coming off his arms. So really with that, you've seen how to set up an Anim trail. Really, it's very similar to a ribbon, really. You are just setting a start point and an end point in the form of a couple of bones or sockets that you're going to use as a like stretch point. So if I was going to take just a quick second and chart it out, which I just need to grab a blank spot on my board for, you'd have something a bit like this. You'd have a start point, and let's do something like that, and an end, and that's really just the first and second socket name. And then your anim trail is just going to extend off of that. So if you wanted something like sword swings, you would simply create a sword that had some bones. So you'd have a bone here and a bone here, and then we could do like, here's the blade of your sword. Like so, and then you know, here's the handle or whatever. And then as your sword swung around, it would create those trails right off of it. So there's a look at creating AnimTrails. Again, very, very easy. That's gonna wrap things up for this video. Thanks a lot.